You've got no right!
You sure you closed the door?
Yeah. Of course I did. What do you think I am? An idiot?
You're not gonna make me answer that, are you?
Richard, looks like Sandoval's got a secret bunker. I'm gonna flush him out.
Let's hope he's still there.
I think they're afraid someone's gonna try to sneak a bomb into the doc's locker.
I'd be more worried about what's in the doc's head than what's in his locker.
If Sandoval doesn't come out of there in a few minutes, I'm going in.
No, you're not. He's on the edge. There's no telling what he'll do.
More of a reason to go in there and talk.
Hell no. I don't want to walk in on him. He might get scared and start popping off shots. Just let him sort out this mess by himself.
Thank you.
Access granted.
And this is why I urge every member of my staff, every man and woman dedicated to the true mission of the Humanity Front, to do the same. Isaias, if you're watching this, I beg you, do not allow misplaced anger to destroy everything we have struggled to achieve.
It's over. He knows I can't come back from that.
Everybody knows, Sandoval. You can't hide from what you've done.
What I've done, Mr. Jensen? I spent years patching people back together from augmentation botched jobs and systemic organ rejection brought on by implants. And now, because of Bill's betrayal, I'll never practice medicine again.
You really want to help someone? Tell me where Seraph's scientists are.
I wish I could, Mr. Jensen. But my involvement ended right after I failed to remove their GPLs.
You failed?
Turns out, my surgical skills weren't good enough to bypass David Seraph's insurance policy. So for all I know, those little implants are broadcasting right now. On a frequency so low, your network specialist wouldn't think to look for it.
You changed the frequencies.
You have your answers, Mr. Jensen.